So now that we have a working virtual machine, or multiple virtual machines in this case, you might want to think about creating some backups. Of course, it's really important to take backups, and Proxmox makes this really easy. So under a virtual machine here, you can actually go to backup, and you can just select backup now, for example, and it will take an entire snapshot of that virtual machine and store that for you wherever you've allocated. It also remembers the configuration of that virtual machine. So if you wanted to see what config you had for that VM, that's available too. You can change the protection so that any sort of scheduled backups, which we'll talk about in a minute, make sure they don't remove that particular entry so that you can keep it safe. So let's say you have the perfect setup and you know that if anything ever happened, just launching that backup or restoring that backup will bring everything the way it was before. But better yet, why don't you schedule them? Let's go to data center up here, for example, and select backup. Now in here, I've already created one, but let's create one together and I'll show you what it looks like. So go ahead and click add. And we've got a couple of different options. Now, we have multiple nodes. You will see multiple nodes. You can leave it as all, but let's say we only want this node to backup. What's our storage we're using? We have one called backups, and that's living on our TrueNAS array, so we'll cover that. The schedule, so how often do you want that to backup? Let's say every day at 9 p.m. Then you can select what VMs you want to back up. So in our case, we already have one that backs up every VM. But let's say you just wanted to back up a few. So let's go with, so instead of all, we'll go include selected VMs. And we can say, I only want you to back up this VM. We obviously want it enabled and the mode is set to snapshot. Okay, so it will be able to run with the VM running and without any interruptions, which is great. If you go to retention, then we can set up how long we want to keep those backups and allow it to cycle through them. Otherwise, if you just keep storing the backups, it will actually end up filling your storage up. So what we do is set up our schedule. So I want you to say, for example, keep the last 7 backups. Now, if I have a policy that says every day at 9 p.m. and I'm saying keep the 7, then we have one full 7 days worth, one per day, keeping 7. Then once it reaches the 8th day, it will remove the first one earliest done. And that will allow you to have a constant refresh and allow the backups to stay fresh and, stay recent, but also give you some time to go back. If you prefer, you can go longer. You can go 14 days, 30 days, 90 days. It all depends on your storage capacity and how big your VMs are, of course. And speaking of that, once you're done here and you submit it, something to also note is that the backups work with snapshotting. So every new backup is only going to grow by the difference of the last backup. So here, for example, you can see how it steadily starts growing because the VM itself has grown. So we have 8, 9, 2, 9, 10, 11, getting up to 12 gig there. And that was done today at midnight. So essentially the VM itself is getting bigger, but it's only going to be keeping the difference. And another reason why we don't have our media stored on this virtual machine. I know some people are asking why we don't have it directly on there. This allows us to back up the actual VM itself separate to the data storage.